First demo is by myself. I'm going to talk about the Argo CD application that I've created. I want to show you a little bit about the structure that I came up with. So, if you have a look at the GitHub organization and the Toth application itself, there's an application called Core, which is basically just containing config maps, a little bit of secrets, configuration stuff that is common to all the components that we are using. And we deploy that to many different namespaces. If you remember that the test environment is just one namespace, the stage environment is many namespaces. So we have one for the front-end services like user API, some for the back-end and the middle tier services, a little bit of infrastructure and the graph namespace containing the database, the Postgres database. So what I've been exploring or what I've been following is the standard pattern of having a base directory, which is basically just creating empty configs or really super generic content in the config maps. And based on this base directory, we have overlays, which are environment specific. Again, you see the test environment, that is one of the overlays. Then we have one overlay for the quick lab environment. And I have created many overlays for the individual namespaces of the stage environment. I have generalized one stage environment. So from an hierarchical point of view, it looks like all the specific namespaces of the stage environment inherit whatever is present in the stage environment. So this is the generalization for all the namespaces. But what's in here? Again, config map, image streams, and a little bit of secrets, and a directory called roles, which is just containing the metrics exporter reader role that we need. If you have a look at that, it is declared to have no namespace, so we can deploy it in every namespace, and it's basically just the role that we have here, pretty long, so that the metrics exporter can read all the stuff in whatever namespace it will be deployed to. Other things that we have is config maps, so a configuration for the stage environment itself. You can, for example, see that front-end namespace, infrastructure namespace have been declared here. Some resource limits. We have push gateways all over the place, Kafka server, and the Ceph specific configuration. All these are inherited by, for example, the front-end stage overlay. And as you can see, there's nothing in there. There's just the customization file and what we use for the chat notifications or for the chat notifications. And this is basically the magic line here. The front end stage overlay inherits everything from the stage overlay and then basically just sends out the chat notification. I've done so for each and every namespace that we have in the stage environment. Infra, same thing. The middle tier, again, same thing. Here, a little bit of Argo is deployed in addition to that. So you see that the specific namespace overlays have additions to the stage overlay itself, to the generalized overlay. If you have a look at this one, the customized file, you see again, I'm importing the stage environment, the generalized stage environment, and I'm adding the Argo deployment and the Argo workflow controller metrics stuff, and again, do the chat notification. I think the middle tier and its Argo deployment and the graph stage overlay directory are the only ones with ha which have additional stuff. For example, for the middle tier, the Argo, and for the graph namespace, it is PG Bouncer, as you can see here. And it is Postgres itself. So that is what I add to these specific namespaces in the stage environment. What else? Right. So everything is basically all the JAML files which declare anything are basically without any namespace. So it's really a matter of the Argo application itself to put the objects into a specific namespace. That is why we have all these wonderful files here. For example, the Argo application for the graph stage environment. It says take everything from the graph stage overlay, deploy all that stuff to the OCP cluster, and put it into the namespace toss graph stage. So everything from the graph stage overlay inherits everything from the stage overlay so that we have our general configuration. And then everything is created in the toss graph stage namespace. So the Argo applications really put it into the destination or target namespaces. Same approach here. Front end stage overlay file or directory gets deployed to our cluster into that specific namespace. Think that's it. That is something I wanted to show. It feels like having the same configuration maps for Toth and Xef in many different namespaces requires this directory layout or Argo application layout, where we have one generalized stage environment or directory overlay, and the more specific inheriting all these configuration from the generalized one. Any questions, comments to that one? Nice. So on to the next.